is there.
What was the craziest stunt or action scene you were doing in Link's movie?
When the director just, you know, Josh just came and lit me on fire, that was pretty intense.
That was intense.
I remember us all actually rehearsing on kind of like slingshot looking things and trying to look pretty badass, holding ourselves together, barely looking heroic.
You got to do a lot of cool wire work. You did amazing. That, I remember watching you do, you know, that whole sequence, and it was really you, and it was just like, that was one of the moments when I remember, you know, you watch the monitor and you're like, oh my god, we're making a cool movie.
I loved sword training. That was my favorite part of it. I still, you know, if I'm out walking in the woods or something, I'll still pick up a big stick and, you know, start twirling it around and stuff. It's just a great skill to have. I hope I never have to use it in actual combat, but it makes me feel pretty cool. So, you know, it's a good party trick.
We had a lot of stunty bits, a lot of action moments.
You had that crazy one where you hung from the falling thing.
Oh yeah,
you know?
True.
Yeah,
that was crazy. Part where we like tilted the whole set and I'm supposed to be falling down. They put the whole like floor on hydraulics and yeah, it was very exciting.
That's funny.
And how about Blue?
Oh, I think I had to throw myself down a hill one night, just throw myself down the hill again and again and again and again. And I did it onto a mat, but it was still like quite a long fall. And I did it, and it was, and I had to run barefoot too. And I ended up like actually hurting my knee a little bit. I remember it was just like really taxing. It was really, it was like scary. It's like you're in the middle of the dark forest and I'm just about like, okay, I'm just throwing myself off this hill now. That was, I mean, it's not as wild as what Maisie did.
Less cool.
Not exactly as wild as I am.
This film has been through multiple delays and a lot of ups and downs, but after all this, in your own eyes right now, did this experience help you shape this film?
Yeah, I mean, it was nice to be able to go back to it after having not seen it for a year, because I hadn't really thought about it and nothing was going on with it. Everything was sort of shut down and dead. So when I went back and looked at it, we did a couple little things here and there just to tweak things that we saw now that we were like, ooh, we could do this. We were also trying to make sure now that we knew it could be self-contained, because when we shot it originally, it was certainly the first of a trilogy. So there were some little things here and there we needed to clip out or figure out how to pave over so that it didn't feel as if you needed a next movie to happen. Hi, Taiwan. I'm so, so happy you guys are excited to see the movie. We think you'll like it.
Hey, Taiwan.
Hi, Taiwan. We'd love it if you would come and see the new Matrix with us. It's really fun.
Yeah, we're really excited for you guys to come and see it.
Really excited. It's been a long time coming, guys.
Hello, everyone. Come and watch the new Mutants. We can't wait for you to see it.
Nice to see you, Anne.
See you next time.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Hope to see you next time. For real. Bye.
Bye.
噔噔噔噔。现在时间中原标准时间是凌晨的4:27。从小编刚刚开始等待这个专访1:30开始，已经过了3.5小时了。我现在精神超级好的呢。我觉得我有一种回光返照的感觉。刚刚做完了变种人的访问，我真的超级开心的，因为这是继上次山下智久还有那个 杰西卡，真的讲错名字 ，Bryce Dallas Howard 布莱斯达拉斯霍华的自己执导纪录片之后，我们又再度有机会和所有的好莱坞明星视讯专访这部《变种人》。这部电影呢，真的是延宕了非常久，已经总共delay 了五次之多。很多人呢都说这部电影是不是被诅咒了？但是呢，从我们看到的片段还有一些素材来看，它真的是一部非常不一样的超级英雄电影，而且呢，其实讲的就是青少年他们也面对的那些恐惧，然后面对自身，其实我觉得还蛮能投射的。而且呢，导演用一个非常特别的手法，就是惊悚片的方式来拍，和平常的我们看到的那种很光明的 superhero 的感觉完全不一样，这次是恐怖片的感觉。所以刚刚在专访中呢，也听说有一些这个工作人员遇到了一些恐怖的事件，因为他们真的是到波士顿市郊的一个废弃的医院拍摄。上一次呢有电影在那边拍摄，就是里奥纳多的《隔离岛》，这次呢他们在那里拍摄。我刚刚其实还蛮怕，其实我问这个问题之前我自己有点害怕，我怕导演讲出个鬼故事我会整个惊吓的逃走。然后还好，就导演他说是有很多工作人员有遇到一些诡异的事情，然后我也问了安雅他们那一组，他们就说他们还好没有遇到，但是他们就是看到很多墙上有一些就是历史的痕迹，会让他们也觉得怕怕会怕怕这次呢，其实专访不少要跟大家坦诚，就是我们还没有机会看到电影，其实有点可惜，因为我好想看这部片。虽然我本人是一个胆子要鬼，然后也很怕看鬼片跟恐怖片，但是呢为了访问我愿意硬起来大家知道我看了《林影仔》，其实也不是，就是我觉得这部片就是很多很吸引人的元素，包括了卡斯，安雅，我们之前在分裂的时候访问过她，真的是一个很可爱的小女生。还有《怪奇物语》的那个哥哥，我也很喜欢她。然后她专访的样子真的是很 freestyle 哈。还有《冰与火之歌》的那个小妹妹，我也很喜欢，虽然现在已经23岁了吧，但是还是就是长得很可爱、很娇小。然后她访问，我觉得。我还蛮希望有机会能够看到他们本人，然后访问到他，因为我觉得他一个人，我觉得他是一个很健谈的女生。像刚刚三个女生，然后就是 Blue 跟 Macy 他们讲比较多话，不真的是对 Alice 很不好意思，因为那个工作人员一直在下面就是出现说请结束访问，请结束访问，所以我本来还想要问他的，就没有办法就被 cut 掉了。Anya 他们那组也很可爱。今天访问呢是1:30开，1:30就要报道，然后我报道之后，你知道我等了多久吗？我等到3:30才开始我的第一组，就是我坐在这里这个位置上定住了2个小时不动。中间有不小心打哈欠，真的太想睡了。我昨天大家如果有 follow 我们的脸书就知道，我昨天下午才访完一部国片，就是可不可以，上个礼拜大家有看到可不可以你刚好也喜欢我。一天接两个访问对我来说是一个很大的压力，因为大家知道报编要自己处理所有的事情，包括整理资料、找资料，然后因为我们的专访不是就是随便问问，就是要看过很多资料，尽可能的去找每个演员的资料，这样他们讲什么你才能就是应对答如流，然后你可以问出比较不一样的问题。你问题也是一个相当艰难的挑战，所以呢两个专访那时候碰在一起的时候，我其实有点想要放弃一个，因为对我来说这个压力真的太大了。后来还好，因为这个晚上的访问比较晚，所以虽然那时候一直也不知道时间，可是我想说下午到晚上还有一点时间可以准备，所以我就觉得好，那我就接下这个重责大任，而且重点是我希望这个全台湾的独家可以送给你们，真的很期待很期待。昨天很晚很晚才接到就是确认信说几点要访问，然后我一算算时差就是晚上1:30啊，然后我就想说那我这样子要提前，就是要提前补眠，不然我真的可能会是整个脑袋是浆糊的状态在访问，这样就不行，所以我提前睡了3个小时。 起来真的很相似，而且我现在肚子超饿的。可是现在吃东西是不是很罪恶啊？就是宵夜，也有很多人就等很久，然后还一直问说：“请问我们有在 list 上吗？”然后他们就一直跟我们说：“呦呦呦，你们不要着急，就是马上就可以访问了。”还好我应该是那整个早上的 group 最后被叫到的，真的很想睡。他看得出来我只睡三个小时吗？好啦，那今天真的很开心，就是有机会，因为我现在讲了多久？今天真的很开心有机会，就是又和大家见面，久违的好莱坞专访。那希望呢，疫情赶快过去，大家都戴好口罩，而且疫苗赶快问世，这样我们就才有机会真的飞出国。然后我觉得真的。和明星面对面跟这种视讯专访的感觉真的很不一样，我觉得视讯就是感觉隔了一层，而且都会等那个中间的 delay 的时差，就是有一点小小的尴尬，但是我尽量就是用夸张的表情来化解这一切，表示我真的有听到。第一个访问到的是导演，很有点那时候有点紧张，因为等了两个小时，就是脑筋已经呈现一副就是放空、快睡着的状态，然后突然导演就突然就 Q 到说要访问导演，所以那时候英文有点就是卡住。后来两组就会好一点，因为我发现小抄可以放在前面。好啦，然后其实呢，其他所有的家人都已经在睡觉的状态，他们还跟我说不要吵。希望他们明天早上不会把我就是打入冷宫，说你不准在半夜做访问啦，我也不想啊。而且因为我们平常飞去国外，就是还有飞机跟可以至少可以睡一觉来调整那个时差，在这里没有办法，就是你几点就是几点，然后你顶多睡两三天，因为你前一天又不可能不工作，所以真的蛮辛苦的。重点呢，就是希望所有的观众，所有看到这个访问的爆笑粉们呢，多多帮我们分享。然后如果你认同我们的理念，然后愿意支持爆编的话，也欢迎抖内我们，或是到我们的募资订阅的网站，欢迎就是每个月只要一杯咖啡的钱就可以帮助我们，因为我们其实是没有薪水的。现在不是视讯断掉，是真的诚恳的很努力的眨着我的眼睛，小眼睛看着大家。谢谢所有参与募资订阅的，有你们真的让爆编可以有东西吃开心。好啦，其实这不是重点，重点就是真的很开心每次在镜头前面和大家见面，那有机会访问到好莱坞明星也才有机会看到你们，那也请大家多多帮我们分享，有高的点阅率我们才有机会再继续为大家争取更多独家哦。好啦，那现在我真的要去睡觉了，现在是4:36，噔噔噔噔，哎，还是应该唱晚安曲，让我们呼道一声晚安，我要自己下楼去，拜拜。